Hello, this is Dr. Hemant. Here I am going to discuss what is a data structure. Data structure is group of different data types which can be processed as a single unit. Means data structure defines how the data is going to be stored in memory. What will be the logical relationship between the data elements? That is defined by the data structure. And what is the data type? Data type means group of data items with similar properties, with similar behavior. In C programming language, by default, there are available integer, float, character, and pointer data types. Data structure can be of two types. One is the primitive, another one is the non-primitive. Primitive data structure means inbuilt data types available in that. That is integer, float, character, and pointer. These are inbuilt data types available. And non-primitive data structure means array, list, and files. And list can again be classified as linear and non-linear data structure. Linear data structure means we are having stack and queue. And non-linear data structure are graph and tree. And in this course, we are going to study all these data structure one by one. So what is a algorithm? How will you define an algorithm? Algorithm, whenever we are going to write a program, the first step is to write an algorithm for that. Then we will write the flowchart. Draw the flowchart for that problem. And after that, we write the pseudocode and then we convert that pseudocode into a programming language. So first, if we are having a complex problem, complex, we are going to solve a complex project. So we never start with the coding. We first define the algorithm for solving that problem, that project, how we will proceed further. So, algorithm can be defined as step-by-step procedure for solving any complex computational problem. Complex computational means the problem that is solvable. The problem that is not solvable in nature, we cannot write the algorithm for that. So, algorithm has some basic properties. The properties are, there must be some input. Every algorithm must have some input and some output. If there is an input, then it will be processed and it will produce an output. Algorithm must have finite number of steps. Finite number of steps means after finite step, it must be terminated. We cannot write algorithm like anything, line 1, line 2, and 10 lines after dot, 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 and so on. We cannot write like this an algorithm. So, that must have finite number of steps. Definiteness, every algorithm must be defined properties, must have some definite result. Means, suppose we are dividing 1 by 0, yeah, A by 0. Yeah, we are writing an expression x equal to 10, then x plus y equal to 20. So, these are not producing some definite results. This is not what is the value of x, what is the value of y, and what is the value of z. We don't know the values of this. There is not any definite value defined for it. So, we cannot write such types of steps in writing any algorithm. Effectiveness. What is the effectiveness of an algorithm? How will you measure the effectiveness of the algorithm? There are two things that are measured for measuring the effectiveness of an algorithm. That is time and space. This time and space is called complexity of an algorithm. So, whenever we are going to define the effectiveness of an algorithm, we will measure the time requirement for the execution of that algorithm in the memory and space requirement to store that program, that process in the memory. So, storage and time is its complexity. If less time, less storage is required by any program, then we call that this is a effective algorithm. Like, suppose we are going to perform a swap of two numbers, A equal to 10 and B equal to 20. We can perform this by using a third variable C. We can use and we can swap this number A equal to 20 and B equal to 10. But we can also perform this swap without using third variable. So the time and space requirement of this algorithm that is not using any third variable will be less as compared to the algorithm that is using the third variable C, because it needs to process more variables. So time requirement will be more and we are using more variables, that's why space requirement will be more. So that is less effective, and if we are using two variables and swapping the values, then that will be more effective. So that is define the effectiveness of an algorithm. So that is all for today.